15. We're going to go to verse number 14. Acts chapter 8, verse 14. If you have it, say amen.
Amen.
If you do not have it, say, hold up, Pastor. Amen. Acts chapter 8, verse 14. Look what the Bible tells us. It says, now when the apostles, which were at Jerusalem, heard that Samaria had received the word of God, they sent unto them Peter and John, who when they were come down, prayed for them that they might receive the Holy Ghost. Can I get a witness here? Verse 16 says, and for as yet he was fallen unto none of them, only they were baptized in the name of the Lord. Mm-hmm. Then laid they their hands on them, and they received the Holy Ghost. Mm-hmm. Amen. That concludes our reading. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to speak from this thought. Say neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor. Pastor going to talk about.
In the church.
Come on.
Beware
of counterfeit Christians in the church.
Come on.
Amen. Amen. Even mama said, teach us. Amen. That just lets us know. I found out, saints of God, that whenever a bank teller is, when they come to work, bank tellers are being instructed to be aware of counterfeit money. And what they use, saints of God, they use real money, whereby people will be able to be affiliated with the real deal, and they can distinguish it from the counterfeit. Just on TV yesterday, they said that over in China, that China has a way of counterfeiting the American dollar. Mm. And they said that, this was on TV yesterday, and they said that the people in China, when they do a counterfeit, they said that the bills become so real, amen, that it's hard for even the people in the federal government to distinguish one from the other. So just last week, saints of God, we found out that on the $20 bill now, that we're going to have Sister Harriet Tubman. Amen. I know it's going to be hard for them for a while to counterfeit that one. Amen, somebody. Amen. Because we know that a lot of folk do not agree with this woman being placed on the $20 bill. But we don't know what Harriet Tubman been through. Amen. Freed up a lot of slaves, amen.
Amen.
It was called the Underground Railroad, amen. And this young lady did some stuff that she didn't have to do. But it was God, come on somebody, who pushed her, amen, to do what she had to do. So as we look at the text, remember the name of the sermon. Beware of counterfeit Christians inside the church. I'm not going to talk about the church across the street or around the corner. I'm going to talk about the Spirit of Liberty Baptist Church.
Come on now.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
But Deacon Reese, I'm not going to call anybody name. Amen, somebody. I just want to let you. My bad. Amen. Amen. I'm not going to call anybody else name. Amen. Not saying that Deacon Reese is counterfeit. I'm just using that for an example. Sister Reese, we all right. We all Well, all right. Amen, somebody. But Acts chapter 8, verse 14, and it tells us, saints of God, that Luke is accredited, saints of God, with the writing of the book of Acts of the Apostles. Luke was a physician, and Luke's name means bringer of light or morning. Amen, somebody. And as we look to the text, we discover a few little things when reading and studying this text. First of all, in Acts chapter 7, we see, at the near end of Acts chapter 7, we see the church's first martyr is the deacon Stephen. Amen. And he is stoned. Can I get a witness here? Amen. Everybody think that just because of what's going on across seas and with ISIS and all of them, that they're killing Christians, they believe that that just started. No, but here's the case of the first one that died as a martyr for preaching and teaching the word of God. Can I get a witness here? And saints of God, in Acts chapter 8, verse 1, we discover that Saul of Tarsus gave his stamp of approval concerning the death of Stephen. And saints of God, we've noticed by reading the text that because of Stephen being stoned, that the persecution of the text followed the death of Stephen. And many of the early followers were scattered abroad. Amen, somebody. Because Saul, who we later find out that his name is Paul, amen, one is his Hebrew name and one is his Roman name, amen? But both of them still mean the same, amen? But saints of God, we discover that the church is scattered all abroad. And saints of God, the Bible tells us that the devil meant it for bad, but God meant it for the good. Because when the apostles, the disciples were all spread out, they had the ability to start ministries where they ended up at. Can I get a witness here?
Oh, yeah.
And according to the text, we see Philip, another one of the seven original deacons, amen. Philip was a colleague of Stephen, and Philip was a deacon, and he was also called an evangelist. Mm-hmm. Can I get a witness here? He seen preaching in the city of Samaria, and he was an eyewitness to the great outpouring of God's power.
Wow.
We're talking about the Holy Ghost, saints of God.
Glory.
Philip was empowered by the Holy Spirit, and he performed miracles. And because of God's use of Philip in such a great way, the Bible says that there was a great joy in the city. Amen, somebody. Our sermon today is beware of counterfeit Christians in the church.
Come on now, come on.
Remember this, saints of God. Just like there are fake dollars, it is no surprise that there also are fake Christians within the body of Christ. Because everybody in the church house is not saved. Even saved individuals have issues with their flesh. Their flesh is warring with their spirit. And a lot of times we give in to the temptation of our flesh. Come here, songwriter. Songwriter said, yield not to temptation, because yielding is sin. And sometimes, saints of God, it's hard for us to distinguish who's a Christian and who's not. So I'm gonna ask you all a question. If I'm standing up and I'm arguing with someone, He cursed me, I curse him back. Uh-huh. And we looking at him and say, which one of them a Christian? Yeah. Or is a Christian? Yeah. Amen, somebody. It's hard to distinguish when two knuckleheads are acting like knuckleheads. We don't know if they're a Christian or not,
but
one thing we know, they're a bunch of knuckleheads. Amen, somebody. And what we need to understand, saints of God, is that we cannot live any kind of way.
That's right.
And if you say that you are a Christian, if you say that you feel with the Holy Ghost, if you say that God is leading and directing your life, that means that you are not your own anymore.
Amen.
Why? Because we've been bought with a price.
Right.
Amen, somebody. That's why I keep telling everybody.
Mm-hmm.
See, we got this thing that we've been raised up saying that we are sinners saved by grace. Oh, I got an issue with that. Because the Bible tells me that when I was regenerated, that I have a new spirit. Amen. The Bible says old things have passed away. Behold, there's stuff that's new in my life.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
And now that I have Jesus Christ, the Bible says that I'm a new creation in Christ Jesus. So if I'm a new creation, that means on the inside, I got a new mind. On the inside, I got a new heart.
Right.
On the inside, I got new hands. On the inside, I got a new will. While on the inside, I have been changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. So, saints of God, I'm no longer a sinner saved by grace. Because if you are a sinner saved by grace, that means you're still practicing sin. Well, Pastor Stewart, does that mean that you don't sin at all? Oh, no. Shall we all come to the Father and have not sinned? The Bible said, God forbid. But we know that if we have on the inside the Holy Spirit, because the Bible tells us that God cannot work in an unclean temple. Can I get a witness here today?
Amen, amen.
So if my temple is cleaned up, I don't look behind my back to see what I did yesterday.
Yeah.
So if my temple is clean, based on the Spirit of God,
yeah,
then I don't have to worry about being a sinner anymore.
Yeah.
Because when I do commit a sin, I have an advocate.
Yeah.
And his name is the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And when I go to the Holy Spirit looks at the Father. The Father looks to Jesus. Jesus said, ha, he's under the blood. Can I get a witness here? Can I get a witness here? And so, saints of God, as we look at our text, let's look at the reputation of a counterfeiter. Simon, saints of God, is our main person in this text. And he was full of pride. Simon was arrogant. Anybody know anybody like that? He was boastful. But Simon was a sorcerer. And he dwelt with the supernatural powers. And he claimed to be someone great. Anybody know anybody like that? They did the best thing since sliced bread. And he's his name means, Simon's name means, he has heard or to listen, to hear, and to obey. Simon is a classic example of a counterfeit Christian. He's astounded the Samaritans with his deception of power. He gained a large following. Sometimes, saints of God, we got to be careful who follows us. Because sometimes the person who initiating the situation, everybody following that person may cause that individual to have a behavior. Can I get a witness here? But he was labeled, saints of God, in the text, he was labeled the great power that the Bible strictly forbids people of having anything to do with sorcerers and witchcraft.
Come on, Doc, come on.
Y'all not feeling me right
come on,
now.
Doc, come on.
There are some of us in here
come on,
who look in the paper and look at their horoscope. I remember when I was young, there was a group called the Floaters. And the Floaters used to sing this song. They used to sing, "My name is Larry, and I'm Aquarius." Amen. And saints of God, I used to be, you know, I wasn't like I am today.
Yeah.
I felt all of that, saints of God. I'm Aquarius, you know, it just blew my mind. Amen. So every Sunday morning, I would look in the newspaper to see if there's something good about being an Aquarius. But saints of God, God frowns upon that.
That's right.
Let me unpack a few if y'all are familiar with these. Astrology. Like I said, the horoscope. Fortune telling.
That's psychics.
Y'all remember they had this lady on TV, she was a psychic. I forgot her name, but I know she was on TV for a good while. She ran for a good while. But all of a sudden, she's not there no more. So saints of God, y'all help me, because I just really couldn't feel it. If she's a true psychic, couldn't she see when they were going to kick off TV? I mean, if you're a real psychic, you should be able to know these things. She could have stepped up and done something to divert her getting kicked off TV.
They had no power.
No power. Amen. Back to the text. There were tarot cards, palm reading, incantations, witchcraft. This is what's going on in our churches, saints of God. Wizardry, charms, spells, and anything else that prevents us from giving God the glory.
Come on, Dad, come on.
Including today's games. We got children that play games. Amen, somebody. Do we know what these children are playing on? There's one game that a lot of kids play, and that's the Harry Potter. There's another game called Dungeons and Dragons. Amen. And there's another one called Card Death or whatever. But saints of God, the way that Satan gets into our individual is that we open up ourselves and allow Satan
to drive
our vehicle. Mm-hmm. If we don't open ourselves to the wickedness, to the unclean spirits, then Satan cannot come in and dwell in a clean temple. Amen, somebody. Because the Holy Spirit lives on the inside of us. Anybody in here got the Holy Spirit? Anybody? I see some hands raised, some not. So I wonder what it is, what spirit has gotten you. The Bible says that God prohibits us from dilly-dabbing with witchcraft.
Right.
Look what the Bible says. Write this down, saints of God, and y'all need to get this verse in your spirit. Mm-hmm. Write this down. Deuteronomy 18, 10 through 12. Look what it says. It says, "There shall not be found among you anyone that makes his son or his daughter to pass through the fire." Now I'm gonna stop right there, because what happened during those times that they were sacrificing their children, amen somebody, sacrificing their children for the betterment of the family. The Bible also says, or the use of divination, or an observer of times, or an enchanter, or a witch, or a chamberlain, or a consulter with familiar spirits, a wizard, or a necromancer, and for all that these things are an abomination unto the Lord. Yeah. And because these abominations, the Lord God do drive them out of and before. And saints of God, God said if you dilly-dally with those I'm going to cut you loose. Mm-hmm. Amen, somebody. That's what the Bible is telling us.
Yeah.
God does not want us to dilly-dally with witchcraft. Right. Amen. Let me make it a little bit plainer for you today. Mm-hmm. So if you're drinking a little tidy for the Bible, or if you're smoking those cigarettes with no names, that's witchcraft, saints of God. Mm-hmm. That's divination. That's you dilly-dabbing with something that the Holy Spirit speaks against of. So why would you, if God delivered you from that, why would you get back in that deep water? Mm. Amen, somebody.
Come on now, come on.
All of us in here,
come on.
We're saved, we're sanctified,
come on now.
We're full of the Holy Spirit. So saints of God, that may be your condition, but it definitely is not your conclusion. Don't go back after God has delivered you from something in your life. If you've been a homemonger, don't go back. If you've been an adulterer, don't go back. If you've been a thief, don't go back. If you've been a gossiper, don't go back. If you've been somebody talking about Pastor Stewart, don't go back. Amen. Amen. I thought I'd give y'all that one for free. Amen. 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 But let's look at the text again, saints of God. First, let's look at the counterfeit Christian popularity. Satan, Simon, saints of God, had been in Samaria for a long period of time. And therefore, he established a reputation in Samaria. He was very popular from the least to the greatest. Indicates that the people of Samaria also loved to give him credit for what he had been doing. So what is it that Simon had been doing, saints of God, that gave him the ability to be so popular? He was an individual who did all kinds of things like looking at the stars, astrology. He was one, if you came to him with a problem, he would let you know, not about God, but he would let you know what he would do if he was in your shoe. And saints of God, he had been in Samaria for a long time. And so they loved themselves some Simon.
Yeah.
But saints of God, we've got to realize that we got some Simons right in the church. They want to be the pastor. They want to be the deacons. They want to be the choir member. They want to be the deaconess. They want to be sitting in the pews.
Come on, Doc.
But saints of God, we've got to understand that the Bible says that I give you pastors according to my heart, where they will teach you, nourish you, the word of God, and give you understanding so that you could march to the beat of the drum by the Holy Spirit. Let's look back at the text. Well, we see that there's a counterfeit Christian by popularity. Let's look at the counterfeit Christian that confesses faith. Acts chapter 8, verses 12 and 13. When the evangelist, saints of God, Philip, came on the scene, Simon discovered that Philip's message, he preached the good news of the kingdom. And when he preached the good news of the kingdom, he also preached the name of Jesus and the power thereof.
Come on now.
Philip preaching was also accompanied by supernatural signs and healings. And this is what caught Simon's attention, because Simon was the one who caught everybody's attention with what he was doing with sorcery, with magic. Amen, somebody. And he drew large crowds. But the moment Philip came on the scene and start preaching Jesus Christ and him crucified, the crowd left Simon and start following Philip. Amen, somebody. And so when Philip was able to say something in behalf to Simon, Simon even fell in. Simon confessed and Simon was baptized also. But the only problem, and this is where the church fits in, the only problem when you're baptized, see, the water don't save you.
Right.
Ain't missing body.
Right.
But when
right.
we are baptized, we are supposed to have a new spirit.
That's right.
We're
That's
supposed right. to have a clean heart.
Whoa.
Amen. We're supposed to have.
Right.
But here
right.
it is Philip. Oh, Philip was telling him that Jesus is the Lord, the Messiah.
Mm-hmm.
And Simon said, I need to get some of that.
Right.
Simon just wanted to be popular again. And he wanted, thank you, I wasn't getting there yet. But Simon, saints of God, here he is trying to be more boastful.
Come on, Dad.
Trying to be a little arrogant. And when he realized the power that Philip had, Philip was able to lay hands on individuals.
Mm-hmm.
And when he laid hands, people were filled with the Holy Spirit.
Right.
And now, saints of God, here he is, Simon peeping this out. Y'all know he was in the booth, in the back, in the corner, in the dark. He was watching what Philip was doing. And everywhere Philip went, Philip preached in this little area, preached in that little area, here goes Simon, follow him. Why? Because Simon wanted to know, how can he get that power? And so here we go, Simon. Simon said to Peter, he said, that power that you have, he said, I sure would like to have some of that. He said, oh yeah, by the way, since I am a sorcerer, see, it was legal for the people who were magicians, what they would do is sell their secrets to each other. You know what I'm saying? Magicians had that ability. If you knew something, and if you knew something, I could buy it from you and find out how to work my little magic. So Simon, not thinking that this is the man of God, he offered to buy the power of the Holy Ghost.
Right.
The Bible tells us that the Holy Ghost is a gift. And when we have a gift, that's not anything that we can buy. The Bible tells us, saints of God, oh, taste and see, for the Lord, he is good. And when he, talking about Simon, when Simon realized that he could not buy the Holy Ghost. Look what Peter tells Simon. If you come with me to verse number 17, it says, then they laid their hands on them, and they received the Holy Spirit.
Oh, yeah.
And when Simon saw that through laying on of hands of the apostle, the Holy Ghost was given. He offered them money. And the Bible says, saying, give me also this power. That's Simon, y'all. That on whomsoever I lay hands, he may receive the Holy Spirit. Simon was so messed up because he was saved. He was baptized in water. But Simon young.